it work this time, Master?
Of course, Igor! It will! I'm going to make the best keycap in the world! It's alive! It's alive!
Oh well.
Hi Digmates, I'm Dominique. When choosing keycaps for your mechanical keyboard, it's essential to consider what they're made of and how they're manufactured. Yeah, and no matter how hard scientists have tried, they still haven't come up with the perfect material for keycaps. The most commonly used are ABS and PBT, each with pros and cons.
In the early days of mechanical keyboards, the consensus was that PBT was of superior quality and that ABS was a cheap, low-quality material.
But is it so? Let's find out. Okay, let's start from the beginning. What are ABS and PBT? ABS and PBT are two types of injected polymers. But what is a polymer?
A polymer
is a material made up of many small repeating units called monomers. These monomers form a long chain with a wide range of physical and chemical properties. Although they're both polymers, ABS and PBT don't behave the same way. Let's take a closer look at what makes them different, how that affects the manufacturing process, and most importantly, the final output. PBT. PBT is an acronym that stands for
polybutylene terephthalate.
Yes, that. This semi-crystalline polymer has a wide range of qualities. It's used to manufacture many different electrical and mechanical components, like electric sockets or light switches. Hey! PBT has several advantages, including high resistance to UV degradation, impact and heat, and additionally, PBT can be combined with other materials to enhance its properties, such as flame retardants for electric components.
Shoot! Flame retardants! I knew there was something missing in my formula!
However, PBT is not perfect. Firstly, it can't be fully made transparent. So to make PBT keycaps with shine through, you need to combine PBT with other transparent materials. That complicates the manufacturing process, but we'll talk about that more later. Second, PBT requires higher melting temperatures, so you need thicker, more expensive molds. And finally, large PBT keycaps can warp during cooling, which means more extensive quality control. This is why some manufacturers use ABS for large keycaps like the spacebar. To sum up, you could say that PBT is like the Hollywood diva of polymers. Elegant and sophisticated, but demands constant attention.
I'm ready for my close-up.
Now let's take a look at ABS. ABS, which is short for acrylonitrile butadiene styrene, due to its unique properties and plasticity, ABS can be used for almost anything. It can achieve a variety of qualities just by adjusting the amounts of its components during manufacturing. That's why it's used in many products, from Lego bricks to automotive parts. ABS can also be mixed with resin pellets to create a variety of colors. And by adding methyl methacrylate to the mixture, it can also be made transparent. Unfortunately, this may reduce impact resistance and rigidity, making transparent ABS more prone to breaking. Another disadvantage of ABS is that it isn't as resistant to extreme UV degradation, impact, and heat as PBT. However, you can improve its performance during manufacturing. That's why a broad spectrum of ABS keycaps is available, ranging from cheap and plasticky keycaps to high-end and more expensive models. It greatly depends on the manufacturing process, which takes me to the next point. How are keycaps made? Both ABS and PBT keycaps can be manufactured using single shot or double shot methods. Single shot. In this process, the melted material, ABS or PBT, is injected into a mold to form the keycap. But that's not all. The legend still needs to be printed. This varies depending on the material used. PBT keycaps either use a die sub technique in which the plastic of the legend is thermally sealed on the keycap, or pad printing, where the legend is printed with pigments.
The biggest drawback of making single-shot PBT keycaps is that light can't shine through the legend. Of course, that's not a problem if your keyboard doesn't have backlight. But if it does, you'd probably prefer keycaps that allow backlight. With ABS, laser etching is the most common technique. The keycap is painted with a coat of highly durable paint that provides texture. Then the legend is engraved with a laser. This technique produces very sharp and durable legends while allowing the light to shine through. It's important to note that in this case, the durability and texture of the keycaps will depend on the quality of the paint used. Low quality paint can wear off with heavy usage. Another crucial factor is the precision of the laser etching process. This is why at Dygma, we have been working closely with our suppliers to improve these key factors. Our ABS keycaps have thicker paint with a textured finish and crisp legends that let a lot of light shine through. Now, let's debunk one of the most widespread misconceptions, that single-shot ABS keycaps are cheaper because they are low quality. Of course, there are low-quality single-shot ABS keycaps out there, but there are ones of higher quality too. It's not the material per se, it's the amount. Some manufacturers make thinner ABS keycaps cut costs. That affects its resistance and performance. Then there's the issue of the paint wearing off. Even the best paint will eventually wear off, but with premium keycaps, it'll take many, many years.
But what if you want to avoid that from ever happening while still having shine through legends?
Then you need double shot keycaps. Double shot. This term refers to keycaps with two layers of plastic, one for the legend and one for the casing of the keycap. Among manufacturers, double injection is a more common term, but most people use double shot, probably because it's easier to remember. Double shot, single shot. Some even call it dual injection, two-shot molding or insert molding. But to simplify, we'll call this double shot. Double shot keycaps are made by injecting two different materials into two different molds. The first injection of material, PBT or ABS, goes to the first mold, where you get the inner layer with the legend. You end up with something like this. If you want shine through keycaps, this material should be translucent. Then, using another mold, you inject the second material, which will make up the rest of the keycap. And here is the result. As opposed to single-shot keycaps where you can make multiple legend designs with a single mold, this technique requires a specific mold for each design. That makes having multiple languages available much more expensive. And as a manufacturer, you have to get the legends right because if not, it can be a costly mistake. Double shot is the preferred technique for high-end keycaps, both in ABS and PBT. One of the many reasons is that since they are thicker, they produce a deeper sound. Also, since there's no paint involved, the legends will never fade. Okay, enough with the science. Which are the best keycaps? ABS or PBT? Well, let's break it down into texture, sound, cost, and availability. No one likes to work with a greasy, slippery keyboard, right? Well, PBT keycaps have a grainy texture that's like a mini massage for your fingertips. Whereas ABS keycaps have a smoother texture. There are exceptions. Some single-shot ABS keycaps can get a texture similar to PBT by applying thicker and rougher paint coatings. Next, sound. Do you like a soothing, soft-sounding keyboard, or do you prefer the sharp, satisfying click that comes with a crispy one? It's important to remember that the sound depends not only on the keycaps, but also on other things like the switches or the keyboard itself. But since we're talking about keycap materials here, let's take one ABS and one PBT keycap of the same thickness and compare the sound they make. Brace yourselves for the shocking truth. There are expensive and cheap options for both PBT and ABS keycaps. But honestly, ABS keycaps will always be slightly cheaper than their PBT counterparts. That's because with PBT, That's because to make PBT keycaps, the raw material is more expensive, the manufacturing process is more complex and requires higher temperatures, there's high demand and low offer, which takes us to the next point. Dominique?
Last, availability. Besides the more expensive materials and manufacturing process, you must also invest in costly molds to make double-shot PBT keycaps, which are the most sought after. As a result, fewer keycap manufacturers get into it, and the ones who do go for safer keycap profiles, such as cherry or OEM. That makes finding PBT keycaps in less common profiles a nightmare. On the other hand, since the ABS manufacturing process is much easier and doesn't require expensive molds, it's pretty easy to find ABS keycaps for all kinds of profiles and in all sorts of designs. Since keycaps are the parts of the keyboard we touch, choosing the ones that feel good to you is crucial. I can't tell you which one you should get because really it depends on your preference. It's like dating. You find the person that matches you, your lifestyle, and who makes you happy. So go ahead and swipe right on that PBT or ABS keycap set and let the love and typing shine through.
Yes, and obviously,
seriously?
Ready, set, go.
I'm so sorry.